Since When Am I Faust? Chapter 5, Wayward Negotiations. As it neared the third hour of the day, some of the citizens of Canterlot got a bit of a shock as they spotted a small alicorn running through the streets. A maid was following her, and the two were heading towards the castle with haste. I was frustrated. Lily told me that the changelings were planning to attack Canterlot, but I got distracted and didn't listen. Now, for all I knew, Chrysalis was probably already inside the castle. The thought filled me with regret, and I desperately hoped that I could make it back in time. The only reassurance that I had was that we weren't too far behind the others. Behind me, Lily cleared her throat to get my attention, and I glanced in her direction as she said,
"So, let me get this straight. You're saying that she's going to attack during the wedding? I'm afraid so. But how do you know that?"
The hairs on the back of my neck stiffened as I realized my mistake, and I looked at my maid with a sheepish expression.
"It's difficult to explain, but I just know."
My maid looked at me curiously, and she tilted her head to the side as her brows began to furrow. She looked down and became lost in thought. I assumed she was trying to guess how I knew when Chrysalis would attack, but I couldn't say for sure. All I knew was that she was adorably puffing out her cheeks as she stared into space. Her grumpy expression was somewhat amusing, and it brought a smile to my face. Grinning, I extended a wing and nudged her side to get her attention.
"Hey. I want you to stay out of this dispute between me and your mother."
The young changeling looked shocked, and she protested, saying,
"What? Why? I can help!"
I sighed and lowered my head.
"Because it's Orlin, I don't know how things are going to turn out."
She flinched when I used her real name, and she looked down.
"But I... please, just listen."
I wanted to avoid putting her in a situation that would make her fight against her family. However, my words were interpreted a little differently than I intended. Lily looked down at the ground with a somber expression, and she remained silent for a few moments as she seemed to realize something. Swallowing hard, she lifted her head and looked at me with glistening eyes.
Are you going to kill my mom?"
Her question startled me, and I nearly stumbled out of my face when I heard it. In all the time that I had spent in Equestria, I hadn't even considered that as a possibility. I wasn't even sure how to answer her. I had no intention to hurt Chrysalis, but the more I thought about it, the more I reluctantly had to acknowledge that it wasn't outside the realm of possibility. I took a deep breath and looked at the young changeling. Putting on a confident smile, I told her,
"I'll do my best to find a peaceful resolution to the situation. But if she tries to harm my people, I'll do whatever I need to do to keep them safe."
Lily looked down with saddened eyes and nodded.
"I understand. Thank you."
I put my wing over her shoulder as I tried to reassure her. Lily forced a smile as she looked up at me, and I sighed. It wasn't a comfortable subject to talk about, but I was thankful that she brought it up. Looking ahead, I noticed that the castle grounds were coming into view, and we were close enough to see the guards standing by the doors. Gesturing with my head, I got my maid's attention, and she followed my gaze towards the castle. Her eyes widened as she realized that we were almost back, and with a glance, the two of us silently agreed to speed up our pace. We arrived at the castle soon after, and as we got to the top of the stairs, the two of us had to pause to catch our breath. I was breathing heavily, and Lily was panting in the background. Once I managed to collect myself, I looked up at the guards, and they greeted me with a nod.
"Princess?"
"Yes, hello. Do either of you two know where the wedding rehearsal is taking place? I need to get there now."
The urgency in my voice made the guards feel uneasy, and they momentarily stepped back as I looked at them with a desperate expression. The guard on my right lifted his foreleg, and he pointed inside the castle as he said,
Oh, yes, your highness. East wing, at the end of the hall." "Okay, thank you, gotta go, bye."
I took off running, and unfurled my wings as I ran inside. Throwing them back, I used them to push me forward, and I felt myself briefly lift off the ground as I sped through the halls. The guards turned their attention to Lily Breeze as I left, and they stared at her as she stood in front of them. After a few moments of silence, she started to get a bit nervous, and the maid slowly walked past them. They continued to stare as she entered the castle, and then she took off running. She was trying to catch up with me, but unfortunately for her, she unwittingly turned in the wrong direction. Alone again, the two guards looked at each other, and the one on the right spoke up, saying,
"So, we got a new maid. She's kinda cute."
Hearing this, the other guard smacked his forehead and grunted,
"Oh, don't tell me. Is this why you were staring at her?"
"Yeah, why?"
"Ugh, damn it, Dusty. I thought you saw her as suspicious or something. Stop doing that to me already."
"Eh, no promises."
"Ugh!"
My speeding form tore through the halls like a bullet, and dread gripped at my heart as I got closer to my destination. Rounding another corner, I found myself sidestepping Prince Blueblood as he berated some of the staff. I grazed aside as I slid past him, and while minimal, it was enough to turn the stallion's ire in my direction. Frowning at me, the stallion called out,
"I beg your pardon?"
I grinned as I looked back.
"Pardon granted, gotta go by. That's not what I meant. Hey, get back here!"
I ignored the stallion's complaints and continued running. My fears were pushing me forward, and I soon found myself going a little too fast. Coming into the next corner, I had to jump up and use the wall to change direction. Hopping back down, I heard some of the maids scream out with surprise. However, the scream quickly became a squeaking delight as they realized that I was the rumored alicorn ponies have been talking about. Hearing their excitement, I couldn't help a grin as I ran past them, and I lifted my wing to wave. I headed down the hallway till I saw the entrance to the wedding hall coming into view. When I got close, I planted my hooves and skidded to a stop. I found myself standing in front of the large doors, and I breathed out as I tried to calm my racing heartbeat. One of them was slightly open, and I could hear a pony talking inside. The voice sounded somewhat like Cadence, but there was an angry tone in her words that didn't just belong.
What do you mean you didn't get them?
My apologies, Princess Cadence, but
it is Princess Miyamori Cadenza!
Yes, of course. I'm so sorry, Princess, but we weren't aware of those change details.
Then you prove yourself useless. You're fired. What?
You can't be serious.
I am. Get out of my sight.
After hearing all of that, I could tell that the pink pony in there was not Cadence. I looked down at the ground and hit the floor with my hoof.
Damn it, I'm too late.
A wave of guilt washed over me, and I slumped down in defeat. I sat there for a few moments, absorbed in my thoughts. Getting up, I began to step away from the doors, and I started to walk back to my room. However, my ears perked up, and I looked behind me as I heard the sound of approaching hoofsteps. Sitting down again, I watched as the door swung open, and a pink alicorn along with an entourage of ponies walked out. I looked on with curiosity as I saw Cadence's imposter for the first time. She didn't take long to spot me, and when she did, I saw a flash of panic pass through her eyes. She quickly covered over it, though. Hardening her gaze, she walked up and asked with a demanding tone,
"What do you want?"
My ears folded back as I looked side to side. I had already made a mistake. In all my zeal to protect Cadence, I forgot to think of what to say if it turned out to be Chrysalis. Now, I was at a loss.
Lauren, what do I say? Just leave it to me. I got this.
I gave the alicorn control, and her heart immediately slowed. Faust put on a childish attitude, and she greeted the other alicorn. She had a bubbly smile on her face, and she had a skip in her step as she said,
Cadence, I came here to invite you to tea.
I'm busy.
Oh, but you promised.
Faust pouted.
What?
Come on, please.
Faust gave the imposter the biggest puppy dog eyes this body could muster, and she held on to that expression, quivering her lip until the fake princess gave in. With an angry scowl, the imposter grumbled.
Okay, fine, but only 30 minutes. Where and when shall we have this meet? Well, my room has a balcony with a nice view. We can meet there around noon. Alright, fine.
The two nodded in agreement, and then went their separate ways. Lauren walked down the hall a short distance, and then once we were out of sight, she gave him back control.
That was awesome! Thanks, I have my moments.
Thinking about how to proceed, I decided to head back to my room. Along the way, I noticed a flash of pink as I walked by an adjacent hallway. Lifting my head, I looked to my side and spotted Cadence running towards me. She was with Lyra and Minuet, and the three of them looked to be in a hurry. When the pink alicorn spotted me, she threw her wing up and waved. There was a sense of relief that washed over me as I saw her, and I smiled as I returned the gesture. As she got close, Cadence looked at me and asked,
Did I miss the rehearsal?
Tilting my head up in thought, I decided to have a little fun, and said,
How should I say this? Yes and no. You were there, but it wasn't you.
The pink alicorn tilted her head in confusion, and her ears flopped to the side.
Say what?
Simply glad that she was alright, I explained.
Another pony looking like you took your place, but she didn't do a very good job. The disguise was spot on, however she was too much of a bitch to really sell it. Next time you get a stand-in, use one that can at least act as sweet as you.
I playfully stuck my tongue out as I nudged her side, and Cadence's eye twitched at hearing some pony was running around pretending to be her. As I turned to leave, I mentioned to Cadence that I was meeting up with the fake around noon. I suggested that she come by to discuss the situation, and the pink alicorn readily agreed. Smiling, I set off to get things ready. A few hours later, as I was finishing cleaning my room, I heard a knock at the door. Glancing behind me as I made the bed, I sighed in relief as I saw that I was my maid. She looked at me with a bemused smile, and walked over to the side of the bed. Lighting up her horn, she began helping me with the sheets, and said,
You know that I have cleaners for this, right?
I shrugged.
Yeah, but I need to practice my magic.
Lily chuckled as she shook her head.
Alright, less work for me, I guess. I came by because I wanted to tell you that I found a drone disguised as a royal guard. I've dealt with him, but he's likely a scout from my mother.
I nodded as I arranged the pillows.
Oh, yeah, I actually met her this morning.
Lily froze as I said that, and she stared at me with wide eyes.
What? She's already here?
Yeah, that's what I'm cleaning up. I asked her to come by around noon. I wanted to discuss a mutual agreement between our races.
The maid shrunk back as she looked at the side.
I don't think that's a good idea. Mom is, well, unagreeable for something like that.
I nodded and looked down.
Probably not, but I need to try. If there's a chance that we can get through this without a fight, I'm willing to take it.
I turned to face her with a determined expression, and Lily sighed as she put a hoof against her head.
You really want to try this?
Yes, I do.
All right, give me a sec.
She turned and left the room as if to get something, and I stared at where she had been with a confused look on my face. 5 minutes later, she returned with a small jar of pink jelly, and I noticed it had some sort of sparkle to it. Closing the door behind her, the maid held the object forward and said,
"Here."
I looked at her, and then looked at the jar. I was confused, and Lily smiled at the look of bewilderment on my face. Nodding, the proto-queen began to explain,
"Changelings don't like the food and drinks ponies do, so if you're trying to get on Mom's good side, if she has one, you might want to give her a drink that she'll enjoy."
I nodded and took the jar. I inspected it curiously, noticing how the substance inside seemed to shimmer and glow as I moved it. Looking up, I nodded.
"Okay, I suppose that makes sense. But what is this stuff?"
Lily smiled.
"Changelings can stir love in a gel. It's like a water pouch. Neat. So do I just give her this?" "No, well, you can, but for something like this, we prefer a more moderate approach."
My maid then walked over and grabbed a cup from the table. Pouring some hot water from the kettle, she filled the cup and walked back to me. I watched as she opened the jar and took a teaspoon of a glowing substance. She mixed it into the hot water and it dissolved, giving the water a pink hue. Holding the cup out, Lily said,
"I present you with Aqua Amor, the only type of tea that we changelings enjoy."
I looked at the cup with curiosity and grabbed it with my magic. Taking a sip, I was pleasantly surprised. The flavor was mild but sweet. It reminded me of the flavor that you get when you mix milk and sugar. It was weaker than that, but the flavor didn't seem watered down. Looking at the cup with surprise, I said,
"Wow, I was not expecting that. Is that what all changelings taste when they receive love?"
Lily shrugged.
"I can't be sure. Everyday foods are tasteless for us, so we likely taste things differently."
I nodded.
"I guess that makes sense."
Then I took another swig. It made me feel fuzzy. Looking down, a thought crossed my mind as I glanced at the changeling in front of me.
"Oh, I just remembered. Would you mind checking this over for me?"
I walked over to the table and grabbed the paper that I'd been working on. It was the treaty between changelings and ponies, and I wanted to get a changeling's perspective. I gave it to Lily and she read it over. She seemed to grow more and more interested as she read it, and when she finished, the maid looked up at me with wide eyes, saying,
"This is actually really good. I had help." "Damn straight, I did all the work."
Lily gave me back the paper and gave me a few suggestions. While I added those few changes, she prepared the teapot with her special brew. When I finished the changes, I walked out onto the balcony to put the paper into my book bag, and I took the opportunity to finish setting up the table. Lily walked out and placed the teapot on the table, and then she said her goodbyes. It was getting closer to noon, and she didn't want to risk bumping into her mother. Almost all of us know how resilient Chrysalis is, so this agreement may be a bit of a pain in the ass to complete, but it's not impossible. So hopefully, it works. Now let's get on to our stealthy donators. Top donators: TacoCat598, Peter Coldhard, Jay Tin Man, Darkside, Gauntlet, and Only One Thing, Zar630, Strix, Raiden, Narwhals, Black Moonheart, Drake Love Dragon, Pastel Skies, Austin Roland, CrazyKiller557, Stu Hex, Dospo, Madman Stan, Delta Omega, Jack Hedge, Rinscyther9852, Alza Norman, Stephen Bingham, LineGod12, and many more skillful people. Thank you all so much for watching this video, and live life to the fullest.